Now let's bring in great friend of the show, elections correspondent for the Federalist, Brianna Lyman. Brianna, first of all, were you ever the border czar?
I certainly was not. There's only one person here who is.
So this whole thing with Kamala and the border, we're going to get to that in a minute. But first of all, Kamala Harris has now launched her first campaign video. Let's have a look at this.
We each face a question. What kind of country do we want to live in? There are some people who think we should be a country of chaos, of fear, of hate. But us, we choose something different.
Brianna, first of all, I wanted to get your reaction to that ad. It goes on for about a minute and a half, and they're clearly trying to make it seem like they're the positive party, and it's mean old Trump, who's a big, negative, meany, nasty type person. What did you think?
Yeah, I watched actually the entire video, and something she said that really stuck out is that, for instance, she wants to provide freedom from gun violence. And what she really means is she wants to take away a fundamental right that is laid out in our Bill of Rights, the Second Amendment. So that is literally the antithesis of American freedom. And yet she's trying to campaign on being the party of freedom and to cast Donald Trump as this hateful person, which is really unfortunate considering that he just survived an assassination attempt less than, 2 weeks ago. And it is her boss, Joe Biden, who said, let's tone down the rhetoric. They have ramped that rhetoric right back up. What did they think, that, you know, stopping for a few days is going to change the temperature in the country? Absolutely not.
And what do you make of some of the messaging around Kamala Harris and female voters? She's clearly making a big pitch for those suburban voters. Do you think this is going to work?
No, and I think this is a bad leg to stand on for her. Look, Hillary Clinton, one of the reasons she lost is her campaign message was, I'm with her. Donald Trump was, make America great again. I'm with her was a very narcissistic campaign message, right? How could anybody who's not a female relate to I'm with her? Donald Trump's is about prosperity for all Americans, regardless of race, religion, sexuality, what have you. And with Kamala Harris, she's trying to win over a certain group of people, specifically college-educated suburban voters, who Donald Trump lost a bit in 2020. And that really made all the difference in a state like Georgia for Donald Trump, right outside the Atlanta suburbs. And so Kamala's not stupid. She knows that she needs to win over white college-educated suburban women. But I don't know if saying, I'm a woman, you should vote for me, is the way that's going to happen.
Yeah, and let's have a look at some of the polls. I mean, they seem to be bouncing all over the place here after this announcement, and you would expect that. You would expect there to be kind of a natural boost. Reuters even has Harris ahead of Trump by 2 points, 44-42, in a national race. But swing states seem to be still edging Trump's way. What do you make of the polls as you see them? And do you think they're going to sustain this bounce, you know, when we come out of the Democrat National Convention?
No, and like you said, look, they went from, you know, running a candidate who was like the Walking Dead to running someone who, you know, stays up past 4 o'clock and doesn't trip over sandbags, right? So, of course, you're going to see this, you know, revived sense of enthusiasm right now, because Democrats, for the first time in, you know, about 3 weeks, have something to rally around cohesively, and that is Kamala Harris. That being said, with the poll numbers, that Reuters poll, I believe, if I read that one correctly, they had a larger sample size of Democrats, so of course she's going to be up in the polls. Second, Hillary Clinton was, I think she had, a 90% chance of winning just days before the election, and she lost. So polls don't mean everything. And when it comes to these swing states, a state like Arizona, for example, the border czar, Kamala Harris, she failed miserably. And Arizona is a border state. Those people, that is one of their top issues, if not their top issue, because they directly feel the consequences. You know, I'm in New York, I feel the impact of the border crisis, but I don't feel it the same way Arizonians do. And I think that's going to be hard for her to overcome.